Good afternoon, everyone. This is 287. And to those who are keeping the Sabbath today, I hope you're having a happy and blessed Sabbath. Now, I'm going to do a video right quick, meaning just a couple minutes. And it's going to be about denominations. Now, we have to understand that individuals are quick to judge who they think you are based on a denominational claim or affiliation. So if you say you're Catholic or you're of one of the Protestant religions or what have you, people would judge you based on thinking that they understand that doctrine that denomination teaches. So it's almost just as important for you as an individual, if you claim a denomination, to understand what the doctrine is that denomination teaches from top to bottom. Because when you're talking to other individuals and tell them you are of a certain faith, they factor that in and pass a judgment on you. So it's also important to understand other denominational teachings so you can understand what that faith teaches their members. And because people tend to become what they're taught to some degree. But we also know that there are many people claiming to be Catholics, Baptists, Protestant, what have you, but only in label only. And they're not, or they'll say, I'm practicing or non-practicing. So they're not keeping the beliefs of their church. So it is an important factor in determining how people look at you or judge you, because people are very judgmental. So I say that to say this. They're estimated to be at least 40,000 religious groups in the world, at least. And you know that as estimated, the confirmation of that would be totally impossible. But needless to say, there are thousands upon thousands, and the average person can assume that and would be accurate in assuming that. Now, of all the different faiths out there, Protestant in this country used to be the number one group, and in recent years it's fell below 50% down to about 48%. So people have come away from the Protestant group and they're going out in other directions, and a lot of them are becoming non-believers, so to speak, or non-group affiliations. Now, of all the different groups in this country, in the world, a mere 500 or so, give or take, are of a Sabbath-keeping variety. So, of all the groups in the world, the thousands upon thousands, there's a mere 500 or so that keep the Sabbath. Now, that struck me as interesting because when those of us who speak about the Sabbath, especially those of us who keep the Sabbath, like myself, tell individuals that we keep the Sabbath, the first notion or thought that comes through their head is that you are of a particular denominational group. And most people, if they don't make an assumption, they will ask you. Now, the presumption is when you tell individuals, or individuals are aware that you keep the Sabbath, as I do, they will presume that you're one of several groups: Seventh-day Adventists, Jehovah's Witness, or some affiliation with a Muslim group that claims to keep the Sabbath, or that does keep the Sabbath. So those are the three labels that we're assumed to be affiliated with. Now, I'm going to say that to say this. I do not claim any denomination, because I understand a lot of doctrine that a whole bunch of groups teach, and that includes Seventh-day Adventists and Jehovah's Witness and a lot of the Muslim affiliated groups that keep the Sabbath. And my thing is keeping scripture. A lot of the groups, they have their own doctrine affixed to it, and some of those things I don't agree with, and I don't want to be labeled as being part of, because for me, scripture is what I need to keep. I don't want to be judged by telling someone, oh, I'm a Seventh-day Adventist, or I'm a Jehovah's Witness, or I'm a Mormon, or I'm a Baptist, or I'm a this, because people judge you immediately. They think they know who you are based on that. So for me and mine, that stigmatism is removed as far as we're concerned. We keep scripture, and that's what's important, to keep scripture. See, man has created all these denominations, and they pretty much grow by the day as far as what I see. And as they grow, you get leaders in these different groups that modify, create, manufacture, what have you. They come up with their own doctrine and add it to what they want to teach. And that's why you end up with all these different radical groups and extremely religious groups or what have you, everything in between, because everyone wants to be different in their group, so they come up with their own added things to scripture. And not to change scripture, but they take scripture and then they add their own teachings to it for their group. And that's fine for individuals who want to be affiliated with a group. And I find that a thing in life, people want to belong to a group. I don't have that issue as far as myself. I don't feel like I need to be affiliated with a denomination to be in the Word, to understand the Word, to study the Word. I want to focus on the Word and not a bunch of other things associated with a group. So for me, I keep scripture. So all those with questions or assumptions, because believe me, we've received them all, assuming that we're this or that, and we're none of those. So that aside, keep scripture. Understand, I'm teaching scripture, and that's what it's all about. I'm not on a pedestal for any group or affiliation. So, with that being said, I just wanted to get that out the way. And as always, remember, the Heavenly Father doesn't call on us to be successful. He calls on us to be faithful. This is Tube 87. I'm out.